Attention, people. Southside Steve here with Southside Steve TV and my buddy Ted Jenkin of Oxygen Financial. And Ted, I want to talk to you about talking to my wife. Now, okay. I'm good in the bedroom. I'm good talking to her. I can make her laugh. I make her happy. But I'm not good at talking to her about money. It's always money. And I hear that money is what breaks up relationships. Yes. So for me, I'm like, you know, what if I won, for instance, the lottery? That's a part of what I do. She hates it, but I play the lottery. I do scratch-offs. I do regular lottery if it's over like $100 million. If I won, what do I do?
That's the number one ice-breaking question. If you got to talk to your spouse about money, Steve, you say, hey, honey, if you won the lottery, what would you do the money? Because that will tell you if your spouse says, oh, I think we should pay off the mortgage, or I think we should take care of the kids' education, or I want to buy myself a new Maserati. It will tell you where their head's at without any accusing them about money.
So it's not really about me winning the lottery. It's a fun question to see where her head is when it comes to money.
Yeah, because most people don't know where their spouse's head's at.
Mine's actually very sensible, but I'm glad, yeah. Now, family history. I come from a family with no money, but thank God they didn't leave me any debt. She comes from a family with some money.
Well, imagine you come from a family that's always talking about money all the time. We don't want to buy this, or this costs this. It might lead you to get older to be more of a spender because you say, this is what I grew up with. So you want to learn a little bit about their family childhood history of money, because that will tell you a little bit more about how your spouse thinks about money rather than you accusing them about how they spend money.
And as far as being transparent, should a guy have side money hidden away if you think your spouse is the type that would go buy a Maserati?
You can't have the side account. You just can't have the stash.
Why not, Ted?
There's no strip club account. There's no Vegas account and stuff like that. You can actually have that account. Just tell your spouse, hey, look, I got an account. I like to gamble. I like to do a few of these things. Are you comfortable me having $3,000 or $5,000 in this account? Because if she catches you, that's going to really hurt the marriage.
You don't want to hurt the marriage. That's trust. Now, for me, common goals. It's something we can agree on that maybe we're saving towards or investing money in or just having money when we get older.
Well, you know this feeling like you got $20,000 in the bank and you're thinking, boy, I want to get a new Harley.
Yeah.
And she's thinking, boy, I want to get some new tile in the bathroom. So, you know, you got to get on the same page about what you're going to do with the cash in the bank. But longer term, think about something like retirement. Your idea of biking, again, could be that Harley down Main Street. Her idea of biking is to go mountain biking in the mountains, and 20 years down the road, you're just like crisscrossing like this. So
know what each other wants to do.
Yeah, get some common goals.
And the last thing, when you're having these discussions, who's in charge?
The person in the bedroom. No.
Yeah, come on.
No, really, you have to figure out who your CFO is going to be for the family. Who's the person that's going to pay the bills, put together the net worth statement, stuff like that. But definitely make sure you figure out if you can have one joint checking account or multiple accounts.
Yeah.
That's an important thing to decide who's actually going to run the family finance.
And these are tough questions, and everybody has an opinion. But what you want to do is get with Ted Jenkin of Oxygen Financial. Contact him at oxygenfinancial.net, because trust me, this is a fight you don't want to have.
That's true.
Can I get a yeah? Come on.
Yeah, come on.